ज्ञानतिमिरन्धस्य ज्ञानञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। नारायणपारायण जादहङ्कारनाशन रूपानुगमृत प्रेम प्रयोजनयते नमः। Let's have a journey through the beauty of Vedic culture. Culture is called Sanskriti. Sam means complete, perfect, and Kriti means formed. So culture is that which forms you, refines you completely, and brings you to a state of pure divine consciousness. The natural state of mind is called Prakriti. And an isolating state of mind, a distorted mind, is called Vikriti. So culture is a way of eating, praying, art, music, architecture, poetry, etc., which help you to bring your consciousness, your mind, from a state of Vikriti, a distorted, isolating state of mind, to a state of Prakriti, a natural, peaceful state. So, that positive, genuine, and beneficial, and eternally perfect culture is called Sanskriti. Sanskriti is a culture which fill your heart with transcendental positive samskaras, which are good impression that will lead you to a clean mind. This can happen only when the different activities within the culture itself stimulate the people to a selfless devotion to God, based on pure unconditional love for the Supreme Person Himself. In this way, art and music can cause our consciousness to expand and be more situated into sattvaguna, into a state of virtue, into a state of goodness. Or art and music, it can also cause our consciousness to contract and be more situated into tamagun, which is the mood of ignorance. Modern society promote art which is destructive, so is actually an anti-art, an art without beauty, an art whose only purpose value is to transgress some acceptable and normal idea of decency in society. An art which can shock people and make them become addicted to sins, up to the point where sinful life will be easily accepted as a tradition. Also, by promoting sexuality everywhere, the real culture of a society become completely lost. The level of a civilization and the purity of civilization depend upon his chastity. So by sexualizing music and art, then the civilization can be completely destroyed and life become fully materialistic and fully meaningless, and spirituality cannot rise in the heart of the people. This is what we see today. Economy are collapsing, a huge demographic crisis, a collapse of civilization due to losing the spiritual value, and it is all promoted through art, music and media. After that, all the value of society become corrupted and filled up with atheistic mentalities, and egocentric activities meant only for temporary sense gratification of their own appetite. Then the new rising generation will find themselves to be completely lost in a stinky world, surrounded by anti-culture, anti-art, and for them the desire to search for any real, eternally beneficial culture as a base on which their spiritual life can healthy grow will be almost impossible to manifest, because the heart now will be too crowded with atheistic, violent, hypersexualized, self-centered impression, which will lead them to self-destruction. So this modern art cannot be called art, but it must be called anti-art, because instead of bringing us into a moment of breathless stillness, peace of mind, and a deep spiritual introspectiveness, it will actually destabilize completely our consciousness and bring us to a lifestyle filled up with hypersexualism, loss of wisdom, disrespect of Mother Nature, and transgression of the limitation of traditional value. But real art is beauty and brings us to yoga, the serenity and the stabilization of consciousness, peace of mind and peace of senses. So, the beauty of Vedic culture is unparalleled, and the gift which can freely donate is unique. The Vedic holy scripture are saying that even though in this age of today, which is called Kali Yuga, where anti-culture and anti-art is freely promoted in all the environment, still is very, very easy to get self-realization, God-realization, and be eternally situated in our unconditional loving exchange with the Supreme Lord, just by a very simple method. This method is called Kirtan, which means chanting the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, which is the most powerful mantra, which will help us to go beyond all the limitation and contamination of this material world, which can contaminate and affect negatively our consciousness. But this Maha Mantra, just by repeating it, by chanting it and hearing it with a sincere heart, then a person can attain a supreme bliss and divine and self-realization. So this Maha Mantra is Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, 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 Hare Hare. So don't lose this rare opportunity of obtaining this human birth of life, and utilize your time at the best by being always more humble than a blade of grass, more tolerant than a tree, respecting every living entity, not criticizing anyone, only pointing the finger of fault to yourself, and always glorifying the other brothers and sisters. And most important of all, continuously connect with the Supreme and remember always His beautiful form and His beautiful quality, His beautiful associate, His beautiful spiritual world, by chanting continuously His holy name. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.